In this foliage, a stick insect or walking stick can be seen. Try to find the creature. It is the common Indian or laboratory stick insect. This species is often kept by schools and individuals as pets. They are nocturnal. It is an easy species to rear, feeding on fresh bramble, blackberry, privet, hawthorn, oak, rose, raspberry or ivy. Culture stocks of the Indian stick insect are parthenogenetic, meaning that the female lay eggs without needing to mate with males to produce female offspring. By the way, did you spot a walking stick already? Well, we have plenty of time. A little music might be not bad. Yes, there she is. Oops, that's a shock. She immediately freezes. Will she ever start moving again? Ah, but here she goes again. So, we might conclude that the camouflage of walking sticks in their natural habitat makes them extremely difficult to spot, provided that they don't move. Let us simplify things to see how it works. We change this photograph of a walking stick into a dot pattern. We can still recognize the pattern as a walking stick. But with this special background, the camouflage is perfect. The animal has completely disappeared. However, when the pattern starts moving, we immediately recognize the stick insect. So it seems that our brains use rigidity to recognize moving objects. In cartoons, movement is often simulated by moving the background. It seems as if it is the walking stick that moves. The illusion of movement would have been even greater when the insect's limbs had made walking movements. Of course, on any screen, actually, nothing moves. We see only one stationary picture or frame after another. This apparent movement is called stroboscopic. To be sure, the succession of frames of this video, for instance, is rapid, 25 frames per second. So, although the little red girl now seems to move much faster, the frame rate per second does not change. Long before the invention of the film camera, around 1895, this stroboscopic effect was already known. This old-fashioned toy, a so-called zoetrope, produces the illusion of motion from a rapid succession of static pictures. But also the perception of real movement in real life can be illusive. Well known is, for instance, the misperception of seeing a train alongside you at the next platform leaving the station, while in fact it is your train that is pulling out. information from your vestibular system or seeing a lady entering the other train makes you realize that it is your train that is moving. Not all movements can be seen. It seemed that our walking stick did not move during that first minute of this video. But we can't see very slow movements. By means of speeding up the frame rate or by time-lapsing, a technique whereby the frequency at which film frames are captured, the frame rate, is much lower than that used to view the sequence, we can make the movement of the insect visible. So, humans have difficulty with perceiving slow changes in the visual field. For example, try to discover where change is taking place in this picture. It ain't easy, isn't it? And again, focus on the bottom right of the picture. Indeed, slowly a footpath appears through the crop. An additional problem is the phenomenon that people usually do not look at details, but only perceive global visual images. Small changes are often not noticed. This is called change blindness. In a moment, two other pictures are shown alternately. Try to find the only difference between the two pictures. And again, the red arrow directs the visual attention to a limited area. Now you can see the difference immediately. At the start of this video, the stick insect was difficult to find, but now it's a piece of cake. This could be called visual learning. Something similar also occurs in this picture. The apparent random spots seem to represent nothing recognizable. However, with a simple black contour line, a cowboy on horseback is revealed. Allegedly, even after a year, you will immediately see the cowboy in this spot pattern.
With time-lapse, the blooming of this cactus, which takes several hours in the night, become visible. Also, changes over years can be captured by time-lapsing. This boy changes in 10 seconds from 4 to 20 years old. Indeed, also very fast movements we cannot see. The invention of high-speed cameras made it possible to see those movements, like this plop of a milk drop, 200 times slower than normal. The perception of movement is situated in the flashing area at the back of the brain, on the left and the right side. There's one patient in the world known by whom, after a stroke, only both areas were damaged. She can't see movement, so she can't see, for instance, the rising of the drink in the glass. Her vision works as a time-lapse camera. After several seconds, she takes, as it were, a static snapshot of the world. This is a simulation of how she perceives the world. Evidently, the crossing of streets, for instance, is for her a terrifying enterprise. But what happens when we have a blurred vision? Despite the fading of all contours, movement in the visual field stays perceptible. Babies in their first months of life can't focus. They have a blurred vision.
And in the first month or so, and certainly at birth, the world is quite different from a visual point of view to the baby than it is to us. This is pretty much what the world would look like to the baby from inside that cot. Everything is blurred. Things that are more than a few feet away are virtually undetectable. Even things that are close to, if there's very little contrast, as we see from the cot bumpers there, there's very little that the baby can make out and detect.
Then, brightly colored toys are hung in the baby's cot.
As you can see, the world is still blurred. It's still going to be blurred for the first couple of months or so. But there are now plenty of high contrast objects for the baby to see and to stimulate the visual system. One of the things that's going to make objects more visible is if they move.
My goodness, what am I talking about? This video was meant to be for my playlist on sublunary creatures, but I end up with the vision of human neonates. So quickly back to the insects. Regrettably, I never could find a walking stick in the wild, but I did find a praying mantis in the south of France. And made this horrible recording of this interesting insect.